The German Federal Institute for Materials Research and Testing in Berlin, where components are checked repeatedly and common materials are developed in new directions. Civil engineer Wolfram Schmidt is a researcher who focuses on civilization's most important building material, concrete. To harden properly, concrete requires large quantities of cement. But production of the binding material poses threats to the environment. Cement is actually kind of a villain because its production creates very high quantities of CO2 and also requires lots of energy. And we also have to ensure that we use cement in concrete production more efficiently. Africa, in particular, is currently going through an unprecedented construction boom. Thousands of tons of concrete are poured there every single day, a major burden on the environment. That's why researchers are looking for ways to produce the material more sustainably. In Africa especially, there are a lot of agricultural residues that can be used. A large number of plant residues, when burned at the right temperature, produce reactive binders. A visitor from Africa, Kolawole Olanade from the University of Lagos, has brought along samples of a special plant, cassava. Its roots are an important source of food for around 500 million people. But the tough rind that covers the tubers is indigestible and ends up in the environment as waste. The construction industry could use it. Professor Olonada has studied the combustion products that are produced when the rind is burned.
We have tested the ash and we have found that we have produced concrete with it, we have produced mortar with it, and it is having strength, which is one of the major properties of concrete, very, very much comparable with normal concrete that we have today.
But what exactly happens when the ash is added to the concrete mix? How quickly does the concrete subsequently harden? And how much ash has to be added? To what extent can the organic material replace components in conventional cement made from gypsum and blast furnace slag? Wolfram Schmidt sees a lot of potential in the material made from cassava rind. First, we extract the organic components like the starch residues that adhere to the rind. From that, we can develop chemical admixtures that improve the concrete. Then we can still burn the leftover residues to generate energy. And finally, from the ashes that we collect, we can develop products similar to cement and can use them to reduce the CO2 footprint of binders available on local markets. The researchers are trying to understand exactly how the cassava ash causes the cement to harden. To do so, they measure the volume of the molecules that make up the ash, as well as their surface charge. My research looks at interactions between polymers that are just a few nanometers in size. But these additives allow us to manipulate systems at the level of cubic meters flowing at a construction site. And I'm trying to translate that into an understanding of what it means for a bridge, a skyscraper, or any other construction product. At this concrete workshop at the German Federal Institute, Schmidt is receiving a delegation made up of building material testers from Africa. The engineers come from places like Namibia, Botswana, and South Africa. In their home countries, they help create standards for the construction industry. Here, the workshop participants grow acquainted with measurement methods and techniques for assuring concrete quality. But for Wolfram Schmidt, the new construction in Africa goes far beyond improving conventional standards. If you really talk about visions, I can easily imagine that in the course of the next 10 to 20 years, Africa could take on a pioneering role worldwide when it comes to green building materials like agricultural residues. They'll be an immensely important resource for new materials in the future, and the building industry in Africa is just going to pick up speed. So there's enormous development potential and many new opportunities to bring innovations directly to customers. Agricultural residues that can be substituted in cement could be found in every African country. In Nigeria, the cassava plant represents a renewable and practically inexhaustible source.
As long as people eat cassava, there will continue to be waste. And then this waste will also be used. And this is exactly what our research is focused on. We want to produce green concrete for a sustainable society today and then in the nearest future.